I guess this is not the original Myst, because chances are it wouldn't work on a new computer, but this is a remake. You'll see in just a minute. But before I begin, let's play the intro. This is a game that was very important to my childhood because I played this game a lot. And back when it was first released, many people claimed that it was one of the most important games in PC history because, well, you'll see in just a minute.
About whose hands might one day hold my missbook are unsettling to me. I know my apprehensions might never be allayed, and so I close, realizing that perhaps the ending has not yet been written.
So that's a part of the plot right there. Now we travel to Myst Island. I said, this is neat. Take this little guy and take him to go. Now, this is a new feature for the Masterpiece Edition. You can actually move in the classic style where you just simply click point and move, or you can do the more modern free roam. I always like the free roam here. Here we are, Myst Island. Doesn't show you much. And there's a button on the other side, but that's reserved for later. That's the marker, which we'll get to in just a minute. Those play a role as well. There's one more combination here. Get the companies.
Catherine, my love, I have to leave quickly. Something terrible has happened. It's hard for me to believe. Most of my books have been destroyed. Catherine is one of our sons. I suspect Agony, but I shouldn't leap to conclusions. I'll find him and Cirrus as well. Oh, I should have known better than to have left my library unchecked for so long. Well, I've removed the remaining undamaged books from the library and placed them in their places of protection. You shouldn't have to use the books until I return. But if you've forgotten the access keys, remember the tower rotation. Oh, and don't worry, Catherine. Everything will be fine. I'll see you shortly. Oh, and erase this message after you viewed it, just to be safe.
So that's another part of the plot right there. I'm trying to remember his name, but he's disappeared. His library's been destroyed by his sons. And you have to free him. Atrus, I believe that's his name, yeah. So now you have to search for Atrus. I think that's a Riven reference, but I'm not sure. Yeah, Mist Island isn't a very big place, but boy, there is a lot to do. As you can see, those markers I flipped correspond to the tower, which I'll get to momentarily, because I think I missed one over here somewhere. Nope, there's one just across the way. Oh yeah, here's one right here. Here's one of the books.
Bring me your red. I can't see. Need a red, you must. I am serious. Give it up. There is one thing I need to rescue.
So that's one of the two antagonists in this game. I believe that's Cirrus.
Cirrus?
And this is Aknar, I think his name is.
Who are you? Help me. Bring blue pages. I must have the blue page. Come to me.
So that's your objective. You have to fetch the red and blue pages in order to move the story along, but a little bit of a surprise in it, and I'm not going to spoil it for anybody. And here are the books. Like Atrus said, the vast majority of them were destroyed, except for a few. like this one. Basically, the purpose of these books is to provide clues on how to get access to the next age. Okay, so that first book just gave us a little bit of a hint on what needs to be done. Of course, myself playing this game so many times, I don't even know what to do. But for those who have not played Myst before, either this Myst or any other Myst, I'll show you guys how this game works. As you can see, that's the clue to get inside the mechanical age. Huh. Never had that happen before. Because normally, whenever you align the tower beacon to a specific location, it's supposed to give you what the area looks like. That was kind of weird that it glitched out like that. But whatever. We have our clue and we can move on. Very first puzzle of the game. Alright. So basically what you have to do is you have to align these three gears. To get that 2-2-1 combination while the chain... Here, I'll show you. While this chain right here is still at its high... If you do too much, it resets. Oh, the chain's over here. There we go. Alright. First stage. see. Looks like Eknar is a bit of a sadist. Got our very first blue page. Does it brings the elevator to you. Not at all? No. Only one way to go, and that's it. This is the fortress rotation device. I'm trying to remember how this thing works. If you can't remember, there's a little training module downstairs. Start on the south end of the island, and now you have to work your way to the north and to the east. The west doesn't have anything. This is Cirrus's room. As you can tell, it's very lavish and very, well decored. Ooh, look at all the treasures. Basically, Cirrus is guilty of greed, whereas Eknar is a sadist. And it looks like the brothers are at odds with each other. Here's the simulator kit right here. Very handy to keep, very handy to, know. Okay. And it looks like it only goes counterclockwise. So let's see here. So it's about roughly 4 Mississippis, give or take. So let's head back to the elevator and work our way to the eastern island first. Plus, sound also plays a huge role, so here we go. It marked. And like I said, I believe it only goes counterclockwise. Alright, we're arrived on one of the two islands. So it looks like we got the cyan logo minus the little orb and two triangles and a rectangle. Wait, on the northern island? Oh, looks like I must have overshot the, But that's okay. Didn't exactly work the way I hoped, but you know what? Something else came out of it. Okay, so maybe I'll have to count for slightly less. I kind of figured it was going to be that. Because it looks like the real rotation, or the real fortress rotation, is much faster than the simulation. First half. Now we just gotta work our way to the eastern island. These have no significant values. But this guy does, though. So here's the second half. So it looks like the orb and three spikes and half a circle. Alright, I can remember that. Mississippi, now. That should be the Western Island. One thing I forgot to mention is that the audio you're hearing will play a factor later on, but not right now. Now. All right, you should get me out of here. We're back. Too bad our stay's gonna be very brief.
You returned!
You wouldn't return.
Ages to rescue me. I'm Akinar. My brother, I beg you! Complete. Always blue pages. Listen to him. Now listen to my brother. An egotistical fool and a liar. Bring me the blue pages. The red ones. Don't bring the red ones. Been wrongfully imprisoned. I must. I will have my retribution. Please bring me the blue pages. Pages, please.
Oh. So now he's accusing Cirrus of trapping him in the blue pages, and he wants me to bring more. Yes. Okay. All right. Those noises, like I said, are going to play a role later in another age. Yeah, north and south is pretty easy, because they're two separate dings. Okay, east has that hiss sound, whereas west is more of a chirp. Anywho, let's get back to this dialogue. give Cirrus the red page. Gotta get red pages for him. So I'm probably sure you figured it out that the brothers are at odds with each other because one is accusing the other of trying to destroy Miss Imig and imprisoning their father, Atris. In my opinion, they're both nuts. I technically could do this. I already know the three patterns. And if you ever forget, you can always come back. That is the access to the Stone Ship Age. Sounds that nice. The three boys are enjoying their life together as BFFs in their utopia. So that's what the Stoneship Age looks like from an aerial view, which we'll get to in just a bit. So these are the three constellations. Actually, there's eight of them. All of which, well, three of which will play a role. And there it is, the day to night transition. It's already sundown. Alright, so that's our first. Constellation Clue. Back in here. Oh, that's not it. That's just one of the destroyed books. Come on. As you can see, that constellation matched that image, and that's our first sign. Alright, that's one. Okay, let's see what was the second date. Like I said, I know what the constellations are, but where's the fun in that? I have to take my sweet time and learn. Itself. Yep, it's already night. I believe it's the bug. This one. Anyways, I believe it's the snake. Yep, sure enough. Now we go back here. Yeah. Well, it doesn't matter here because I got the ages figured out. Actually, I got the combination figured out. Now we can go on to the next age. Starship age, in my opinion, is the shortest and the easiest. Because there's not a whole lot to do here. You can see everything's pretty much flooded. Earlier because it was water now. Now we made it much lighter. Come on. Head up the stairs. There we go. Within a treasure chest. How original. See, it's at 135 degrees. We'll play another role later. Now, since as long as you have that all memorized, you can go ahead and hey, you don't need the lighthouse unflooded anymore. Thank you. seems like Cirrus is not only an addict, or a rich, greedy individual, but he's also an addict. I know there's a way you can get out of bed. That's where you can actually get behind the plants. Fabric. There's the red page. It's really just the pot calling the kettle black. Ooh, full moon. Let's go get the blue page and see Aknar's side of the story. Dark type. Sirius's. Alright, here's the most important item of the game. One half of the white pages. Like I said, the Stoneship Age is the shortest and the easiest of the ages to beat. Tell by this point, like I said, they're both nuts. Anyways, on to the next age. Thank you. birds chirping at night. Okay, so this is the generator room. We have to power up 59 volts exactly. So yeah, there it is. Alright, so anyways, let's read on the, or let's read about the Ascendantic Age. Okay, it looks like this part of the sensor started to fade. Yeah, it looks like part of the text has been faded. So this piano right here is the clue. And one thing I noticed is that there are 36 keys altogether. There's 7, 5, 7, 5, 7, 5. So that's 36 keys altogether. That's a bit of a dirty trick I learned. I know 3 is the highest. So let me see here now. Okay, so let's see here. Oh, looks like I gotta bring those two. So the fourth one is number 13. Alright. Oop, didn't want that. Up, so it turns out I gotta bring numbers 1 and 5 back down 2 octaves. There we go. There's that again. Number 4 is 13. Number 2 is 20. Number 3 is 23. Of all the ages, this is the longest. I think this is also the trickiest, too. Let's see if I can just a short bit. Another page. Like wind, some sort of wind chime of some sort. I don't know. Looks like there's a very specific order. Okay. archive. This is why this age is actually the longest and the hardest. Because of this subreddit right here. So back at the back in the mechanical age, every time you rotated the fortress simulator, depending on which direction you go in, it made a very specific sound. And in the case of the north, it was ding. Plus, I also know west was the chirp sound. Like I said, north and south have very distinct ding sounds. I forgot to mention that sounds will combine, and I'll take you in an even more specific direction. As you heard just now, the cowbell and that chirp meant southwest. Of course, though, once you have it all figured out, it's real simple. Thank you. Like I said, if you don't know what you're doing in the Celentic Age, which is why it's the longest and the hardest, you're going to spend forever there. But once you have it figured out, it's real simple.
My friend. Bring in the blue pages. I see. Convinced the Cirrus is guilty. Pray, do not release him. He will destroy me just as he can. The innocent bystander. I've been wrongly tricked into imprisonment. Didn't you have observed his unbridled lust for riches? In the four remaining worlds. Some plot. It was almost perfect. Final blow to father. He tricked him into believing that it was I who was the murderer. I didn't murder father. Bring me the remaining. Just please. A liar. Full in a liar. Must not be free. Or it would be. Remaining blue pages from the last Age of Mist. I must be free. You must free me. I cannot bear it here for eternity. Free me.
Now the plot begins to thicken. It's already sunrise. This time around is hard, a little tricky to find. Oh, there it is, it's up there. Got it. Go through this again. Thank you.
which I can see more clearly. Soon, be free from this horrid prison. This book. You must visit the one remaining aid. You have not.
That would be the Channelwood Age.
And my brother Akinar is demented. He is guilty. He took advantage of the freedom our father had given us. Akinar be guilty. I ask you again. Not retrieve the blue pages. He will destroy both myself and you, just as he destroyed the other pages you missed. Never will escape. You must simply bring the red. Tell me the story that I hear. Your wisdom. You will see that I am innocent and he is guilty. This forgotten island long ago. I will owe you my life.
Said there's one more age to visit, and that is my personal favorite age, the Channelwood Age. But before I go up to the tower, oh, that's not it. Let's read. There's an age that does not exist. Asmoyan age. Yeah, that's a fictitious age. So that's just a small glimpse of what the Channelwood Age has to offer. Daytime. I think the internet transition of this game is a nice touch. Alright. Now that I got the tree at its maximum, I gotta bring it down. Thank you. Alright. The last stage of the game. And like I said, my personal favorite. Pipes. This is correct. I have to have a very specific platform. Over there. Now if you have a bridge. Okay, so I do not need this connected anymore. So now I have to focus on getting water to the elevator. I think this is the... Yeah, this is the first elevator I gotta connect it to. I believe from this point, yeah, we only have to flip this switch, I believe, to get the elevator over there working. But for right now, let's just concentrate on this. There's a way you can open that door. That's very... But it requires a lot of backtracking. Can't believe this door is connected to that. Can't remember how to do this. check something real quick here. Oh no, wait a minute. Now I remember. There's a switch you gotta hit. I think it's in the middle. I believe it's connected to a dead end. And it faces the door. Not that one. There it is. Alright, perfect. Once you get that door open, then you no longer need that elevator. Alright, perfect. Alright. Alright, I'm gonna actually stop it here for now. Thank you all for watching. I'll see everybody next time.